My family and I have owned electric vehicles now for over 5 years. And in that time, we have taken our electric vehicles on many different road trips all over the United States, going tens of thousands of miles. And in that time, there have been a handful of situations where having an extension cord for a Tesla charging cable would have come in handy. Now, I'm not talking at superchargers because there aren't really supercharger extension cables yet, but I'm talking destination chargers, say at a hotel or at a restaurant or wherever. And typically it's in a situation where there is an ICE car sitting in the way. So the plug is available, it's not being used, but you can't reach to it because there's cars in the way. And so that's where a product like this that EVDance sent me to evaluate would come in handy. So you can see this is a Tesla NACS extension cord. NACS stands for North American Charging Standard and is basically the Tesla plug if you're familiar with that terminology. This is a 21-foot cord. And as you can see here on the box, it is UL listed. And down here, it is flame retardant material, UL94. And then also here on the back, you can see that it's specifying that it can go up to 50 amps or 12 kilowatts. It's 21 feet long and is IP66 rated. So in today's video, I'm going to unbox this, see how it comes, and then we'll go try it out. First off, this box that you're seeing here came in a larger box, and that's relatively unimportant, but it came well packaged. It came in a bag. So this is emblazoned with the EVDance logo. And I should probably clarify, they did send me this for free, but they didn't dictate that I say anything specific about it. So I'm just sharing you my honest thoughts and opinions based on my experience. So here on the top, we have a zipper, and this is the extension cord itself. And inside it comes with, it looks like a manual for it with additional information if need be. And we'll look at that in just a second. The extension cord itself comes packaged with some bubble wrap on the ends. So I'm gonna get these taken off and then I'll show you what the plugs look like. I have finished getting all the wrapping off of it, and you can see it comes with two Velcro ties here to hold it together. So I'm gonna take, well, I'm gonna leave those on for now because I'm gonna carry this upstairs to go try it on the cars here in just a minute. But looking at the plug, you can see, oh, it's got some protection here, plastic on it. So that's branded as an EVDance NACS plug, and it definitely looks pretty standard Tesla plug, and that's good. Looking at the cord here, I like that it's a fairly flexible cord, and it's thinner than many other extension cords that I've worked with that are rated 450 amps. This is nice and thin. It is stiffer than the mobile connector plug that comes from Tesla, which has about the same diameter, but is a little bit more flexible than this. But I'll get it unraveled and next to the car and we'll see how well it performs. I'm sure it'll be just fine. It has some print right here on the cord. Hopefully you can see that all right. And it's basically showing right here that it is 8-gauge wire, which sounds about correct for 50 amps. It also has the specifications here on the side of the box, and this is clearer about the cable gauge right here. So it's indicating that two of the conductors are 8-gauge, and that's for the transmission of the actual power of going up to 50 amps. And then one of the wires it's showing is 10-gauge, so I'm guessing that's the grounding wire. And then it's showing there that two are 20-gauge, and so those are communication wires. And then also the cable's material is made out of TPE, plus nylon, plus the copper for the wires, of course. Looking at the other end of this extension cord, you can see it has the receptacle there for receiving the input from the supply end. And then right here, it has a toggle or some kind of a switch that I'm guessing, yeah, it does say right there that it locks it on. So lock for there, and then right there it shows open. So you push down and open it. And then also it has a dust cap right here that obviously goes on the end of that right there to keep that clean. And then let's look at the manual briefly here. So it's giving the information about the model number and stuff like that. And then here on the inside, it just has the standard warnings for various purposes. And then over here, product specifications. So I'm just gonna scan down that. You can see the product specifications there. And then product overview, it's a cable, it's just an extension cable, so it's pretty straightforward. And that's about it. It has some information here on the back of how to connect it and how to disconnect it. So let's go test this out and see how well it works. Now here's my current situation. My travel trailer has solar panels on the roof, which are exclusively charging my Model S right now, at least during the summer. I haven't decided when I'm gonna stop that experiment. This right here is a mobile connector that's going around into that travel trailer to an outlet that I installed. But there are times, and there will be coming up in this winter, when the trailer won't be producing enough energy, and I definitely need to have energy coming from the house into this car. And as it stands right now, in a past video I made many years ago, I talked about this solution that I came up with, where this Juicebox Pro 40 is right over here, plugged into the wall of the house, and then the cable is coming along this metal bar. I'll put a link above to this solution that I made. But basically, it has zip ties and things holding it along here, and then this is the actual charge handle right here. Normally, I would take this off and plug it into the vehicle to charge it. Well, this cord does not reach to this vehicle that's out in the driveway. So if I wanted to charge this vehicle, I have to juggle the vehicle. So I have to drive this one out of the driveway, and then I would have to move this vehicle over into this spot and then move them back and forth because of the length or the limited length of that cable end. So now with this extension cord, I will be able to charge either vehicle in either location with this extension cord using my Juicebox Pro 40 here. Now, to be clear, this right here is a J1772 charger that I've been using, and then I just use the standard adapter that Teslas all come with to adapt to the Tesla plug. So I wanted this extension cord, which is a Tesla plug, even though I technically could have used a J1772, and then this adapter would have been at the other end of the cord now. But this is the future, Tesla's connector. So I wanted an extension cord that I will be using in the future, like someday this Juicebox Pro 40 will go away or whatever, and I would just be able to have a native Tesla all the way through. Or in future, when I'm using this on road trips, most likely we'll be using the Tesla connector in those situations. So I already have that adapter on right now. So we're going from J1772 to the adapter, but doesn't really matter too much. And then here we have the extension cord, and it just plugs in just like that. And then, like I talked about, there's this switch. So you can lock it and then it stays on, or you can pull it back and then it slides right off. And one thing I found is that you can actually lock it ahead of time, and it just resists pushing it in more, and then it kind of clicks in and then stays there. And I don't think that would be hard on it. Based on what I'm seeing, it puts more pressure on the internal plastic clip. Maybe that would not be good long-term. So maybe it's better to open it, push it in, and then lock it. And now it's pretty locked in. Now, in my case, I'm going to just hang this up right here. And so that cord is all going up there. And then this is the extension cord length right here. And then also, now that I'm getting a chance to kind of use this cord, it is very nice and pliable. It's definitely not stiff compared to some others that I've used in the past. Now, clearly I don't need to use the extension cord in this setting, but this is the car that I actually want to charge right now, because like I said, I'm doing an experiment with the Model S where I'm only charging it from the trailer. And I'll be doing a video later someday about how that goes, because I've been doing it since March and now it is August. And so if you're interested in that video, then subscribe to my channel and you'll get notified when that video drops. So let's go ahead and test the extension cord here on the Model Y. So I'm going to plug this in, and yeah, actually I'm going to test this. So it's now charging, and I'm going to hit the unplug button you can see right here. And yeah, that functions. So that functions as a plug to control the charging, and it feels good and firm, and this feels the same as a native plug, which is good. To be clear though, this button that says unplug, it only is for unplugging. If you press it, the normal Tesla plugs will open this charge port door, and in this case it does not. And here is another example of a way to use it. You can see I've unhooked it from that hook and it's just hanging down, and this is where the adapter, you know, the beginning of the extension cord is. And now I'm running the cord all the way out here, and I can be charging a car in my driveway. And normally in the past, we've always had to back the cars in because of the short distance between the charge port and the house that we needed to match. But now with this extension cord, I don't even have to back in. And I could potentially have a car here in my garage, and I could have one in my driveway, another one over here, and I can reach all of them. Like if friends visit or something and we want to be able to charge them, they don't have to be backed in, and I can still reach them there in the driveway. And also this cord is long enough that I can bring it along all the way over here, and I can still shut the garage door for security purposes and just have the cord going out all night, even though it's coming down from up here. And so here in the car, you can see I have it set to charge at 40 amps, which is the maximum my Juicebox Pro 40 will do. And it's dropped the voltage down to 227 volts. Right now, what I'm going to do is we're at 48% and I'm going to charge it up to 65% to give it about an hour and a half of time to build up some heat, and then I'll come back with my thermal imaging camera and check how much heat has built up on the cord. Now, the one reason why I point out the voltage is because a lot of people refer to this type of outlet as a 220, right? And so that 220 volts is the lower end of what the voltage should be before it's problematic. And the normal voltage from the grid is 240 volts, and that's about where this was when before we plugged in, probably. For instance, if I lower the amperage over here all the way down to 5, so it has much less of a load on the system, you'll notice over here the voltage is now 235. So it already has a little bit of voltage drop with just 5 amps. And the thing is, the longer the cord is, the more heat buildup there is and resistance, and the resistance is causing the heat buildup, and thus the voltage drop. And so you don't want to have a lot of voltage drop. If the cord is too long, that's a problem. And in this case, it's not a problem. 227 volts is totally within the normal 20 volts of range. At, if you know, 40 amps, that's the most that this circuit can pull, and I'm happy with that voltage drop. The car has now been charging for a little over an hour and is at 62%. Also keep in mind, it is 87 degrees here in the garage right now. And here you can see the extension cord on the floor. And I left it coiled up right here just to show, you know, that sometimes there's heat that builds up if a cord is coiled on top of itself. There's, you know, less ventilation and it's condensed heat in one area. So right here where they intersect, looks like it's just over 100 degrees, 105 degrees. And then if we come up over here where it's going into the vehicle, it's about 97 degrees, 98 degrees or thereabouts. It's 104, 105 degrees right here out of the cable. And when I put my hands on it, it's just a little bit warm. It doesn't feel too hot or anything. And then over here where the handle's going into the car, it's still about 100 degrees. And then over here at the other end of the cable, it is just about the same, about 105 degrees. I guess this is hotter here. This is 113 degrees, and this is right where the end of the extension cord goes into the J1772 converter. But you can see the heat mostly is coming from right where the junction is, but when I touch it, it still is not hot. It's just a little bit warm. So overall, I'm happy with the performance of this extension cord, and I highly recommend getting it because this is great to have this additional 21 feet.
Overall, I'm very happy with how well this extension cord has performed in my minimal testing that I've done, admittedly up to this point, but I will definitely continue to use this extension cord, especially on future road trips where it comes into play. And something else to think about, I'll put a card above to a video I made a couple of years ago where I had talked about being able to extend the cords that charge your electric vehicles when you're on road trips, and how at that time, there weren't really very many, if any, if I remember right, Tesla extension cord options. And Tesla's own mobile connector is only about 20 feet long. So it's just woefully too short if you're trying to charge out of someone's dryer outlet way deep in their house. And so I came up with a charging solution where I have third-party adapters that I can plug into a variety of outlet types. And then I have a 30-foot, 50-amp RV extension cord that I then plug into that adapter, and then I plug in the Tesla mobile connector into that extension cord. And I have used that very solution in many different circumstances over the last many years going on road trips. What I will now be able to do is use that extension cord still, but now in conjunction with this one if the voltage drop isn't too much. And thus I will be able to have 30 feet combined with 21 feet combined with the 20 feet of the Tesla mobile connector. So I'll be able to go really long distances, but I will have to experiment with that on a future trip to see if the voltage drop is too excessive. And maybe I will just drop the 30-foot RV extension cord in that case, and I would just plug the mobile connector directly into the outlet type and then be able to use this Tesla extension cord on the end of it. And in that case, what you're gaining is the intelligence that is the Tesla mobile connector adapters, because those adapters automatically adjust the amperage that the Tesla is pulling from that circuit based on the circuit type and the maximum amount of amps that that circuit can handle, minus 20%, because it follows the 80% rule. Just go follow that video I linked, put a card to above just a few minutes ago, and watch that video and you'll see more of what I'm talking about. So this extension cord is a really great solution for people who don't want to be adjusting amps manually in their car, they can just use a mobile connector and use this extension cord on the end of it, and they'll still have an additional 21 feet. It's a little bit shorter, you know, 9 feet shorter than that 30-foot extension cord that I've been using. And in a lot of situations, that would be okay. I hope this has been helpful to see how well this extension cord has worked for me now, and I will continue to use it in the future. If you're interested in picking up one for yourself, I will include a link in the description below to this extension cord. And with that, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.